CMS, usually the problem is that they upload nice images, 5 megabytes or larger even, maybe. So you really want to actually cache that and make sure that it's not being transferred over and over again. About integrating it in a CMS, I don't think you can give the users any tools to do that, probably. But I would stick to saying, well, what assets do we always need on this website and make sure that they are there already. The dynamic cache can also be done for pages, but then you have to do something extra to check, I would say, serve that page, but fetch it as well because it might have been updated, and dynamically replace it, for instance, and put it in your cache again. And if it's the same, then, well, nothing happens.
That makes sense. So why do you use the local storage for checking if the page is cached or not? Isn't it possible to check the dynamic cache instead?
Yes. I was going through my slides last night, and I was thinking, because I created this talk last year, and I was like, why do I do this? And then it hit me, it's one particular reason. I need to have the version of the dynamic cache, because I don't know which one it is. You might go around and just saying, well, give me anything in a cache. But the other one is, I store the anchor tag there, the title of the page in there. If I don't do that, I can only say, well, you can go to HTTP, etc., etc., .html. So that's the reason I'm putting it in local storage, to present it nicely to the user.
Yep, makes sense.
Is it my turn? Because the next question has a really cool word in it. Is it really faster to store already prefetched links in the local storage? Couldn't the service worker do the deduplication? Oh, good question.
Yeah, good question. Let me think. Probably. But I have to say, again, we need something in local storage to give a proper link.
So for the same reason.
For the same reason, because you want to show a nice list. So yes, probably you can do that in the cache as well. But yeah, you have to write it into the local storage, so why not check it there? For me, it's easier. But
does it work? I hope.
Yeah, is that okay?
Okay. It's obviously cool to have those pages cached, but what about if the page is updated? How does the update of the storage work?
Yeah. I did it included in this presentation, but as I mentioned before, what you can do is just serve it. If you have it in the cache, just serve it and immediately go to the server and see if there's a new version of it and replace it. That's something you could you also could do with, if you're calling an API for data, for instance, just showing, well, this is our maybe you need to put some information around it. This is the
state of data.
Yeah, something like this. This is from yesterday, and in the meantime, you get new data and just display that. That's a way of doing it.
I think we are running into a really interesting combination of a very engaged audience and a very interesting topic.
Because I'm happy with the questions.
Are literally still coming in.
Yeah.
I just got another one that is, how does service worker caching for things like images improve upon the existing mechanisms like default browser caches if actual offline functionality is not a target?
It's faster. And also, it's being saved over time. I think the caching you do with a service worker has a limit of about, I think, 10 or 15 megabytes per service worker. Browser cache is like, yeah, I'm full, I'm just going to throw things away. So you don't have any control on that.
All right.
I think there's no update anymore.
I'm checking. No more new questions. I have one last question.
Yeah, me too. But you go ahead.
Please.
Yeah,
only okay. One can have a last question. So
no, we.
I grant you the second to last question.
That's
because mine is baller.
Coming back to the topic of, and I forgot what I wanted to ask.
Cats,
yeah, exactly. How do you approach cats with stored content? Like, won't they get squished or something?
Yeah.
Do they get stale? No, but actually, the topic about implementing it in any website, and especially in a CMS, Do you have any experience, or have you experimented with predictive caching? Because that would be something in a bigger website, if you have statistics which site or which pages people visit after another, then you could maybe, you know, pre-cache those.
True. And the easiest way to do that is put it in the static cache.
Yeah.
Add it to that list you already have there. Make sure you update the version number, otherwise things might go wrong. And then you can do that, yeah. I'm not sure if you want to have a list of hundreds of...
Of course.
But
top 10 or whatever.
Yeah, something like that.
Last question. Yeah? On a scale from 1 to 10, how much do you love Jurassic Park? Feels like a solid 15.
No, it actually, I'm sorry to say, it's probably a 7 or something. If I create a talk, it's like, okay, where's my first thing? Well, the dinosaur in Chrome, how can I relate to that? Oh, Jurassic Park.
And then you buy a t-shirt.
And then I buy a t-shirt, make my slides like that.
It's
like,
perfect.
That's commitment.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, don't forget to rate this.
You're welcome.
Don't forget to rate the talk, and we'll see you here again for the next talk that I forgot to look up.
14 minutes.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See you in 14 minutes up here or down there. Thank you so much.
Thank you.